You want to be more productive in developing a great quality report dashboard? In today's video, I'll share with you my productivity tips to produce a report faster. Most of the strategies that I share today is going to be quite generic. So even if you're not a Looker Studio fan, you can still apply to other data visualization tools out there. As this channel is mainly for Google Looker Studio tips, I would also share some steps on how to do them in Looker Studio. If you want to steal some time from your work, make sure you stick around and let's go. Hi, this is Sessa from the Analyzer. Last week, I posted a poll asking your help to vote for today's video, and you guys did. Thank you so much. So today, I'm going to share all the tips on how to work productively as a BI developer. These are the tips that I've learned from my job as a data analyst from the past few years. I hope you find them useful and let's get started. So the first key point to make sure you stay productive at your work is actually to fully understand the requirements by talking to your users before you start developing the dashboard. So imagine this is the requirements that you receive from your boss saying that the sales team needs a report showing the bestsellers for the past 1 month period. At this stage, do you think you can already start developing the dashboard? Please leave your answer yes or no in the comments below and explain why you think so if you're happy to share. For me, I think the answer is no. Why I think it's no is because we haven't really talked to the users and we didn't have enough info and context about the specific task or the project. I find that developers tend to jump straight into the job right away after they receive the request because they are too excited for it. But from what I see, the requirements here is pretty vague. What do they mean by the bestsellers? Does it mean the quantity sold, or do they take the bestsellers based on the total sales generated? Well, some may say we can assume that the bestsellers would usually be the total units sold. We can also give whichever charts or tables that we think is most suitable for their use case, but would it be more efficient for your work? What if they don't need all the charts included, but they need other things? So you might be spending time building the features that you think they need, but actually not. For me, it's just not the most productive approach. So I always prefer setting up meetings with my users to understand and gather their requirements. You may ask the users to share their pain points, and if possible, ask them to show you how the reporting is currently being done in their own way, which is the current workflow. And you can also ask them why it doesn't work anymore. This not only helps you to understand the data points needed by the users, but also helps to understand their operational needs. And most importantly, it helps you to ensure that the report you created meets all the needs they have. In short, we're going to be user-centric when we build our reports, and that's how we can stay productive. Second, wireframing. A well-designed dashboard is able to display more information within the limited space. Before you start developing, sketch the layout. This will serve as a guideline to you as a developer while developing the dashboard. Also, if you have opportunity to share it with your clients, it is also a good way to validate if this final outcome is what they are looking for. How I would usually do this is I take out a paper and start adding the title, the charts, the slicers, and the data points that I think it would be needed in the report based on the earlier discussions with the users. So here is one of the sketches that I did. If you prefer a digital way, you could use any online drawing tool out there such as Figma. So now I'm going to share with you my dashboard wireframe that I've created in Canva, which is on the left-hand side. Then at the right-hand side is the final outcome of the dashboard, which I have created in Google Sheets, but the concept is very similar. It helps me to see how much scorecards that I need to put on top, how much slicers that I have to add in, charge the table that I have to put in, what is the field name that I have to add in, and this would give me a very good control or judgment of how I should create or how much space I should reserve for each element. Very often, developers are asked to design the reports and dashboards following the brand theme. By applying colors specific to the brand and adding the company logo, it creates a familiar look and feel to the brand, and hence it promotes more ownership of the report. So imagine that we need to set up all the interface and the custom theme from scratch every time when a report is requested. It will be a nightmare. So the simple trick that I've learned is to create a branded template. This will serve as a starting point whenever you start building a new report and save you time for other tasks. What I mean is that you can create a report that doesn't have any data in it, but built in with the titles, the company logos, the custom themes, the box shapes, all the things that you need visually to make the dashboard looks presentable. Then every time when you create the new report, you're going to come here and make a duplicate so that you don't have to redo all the setup again. This method would be useful if you are working with a team and you want to standardize the report format and theme to look professional to your clients or other departments within your company. Another good way to save your time is to find a pre-built template that has already got all the metrics and info, all the charts you wanted in the report. So I'm going to show you a template that I created for my own website performance tracking. If you have a Search Console account with the data track, you could literally copy this report I've created, switch the account to your own, and you will have your report churned out in under a minute. You have the full edit access, so you can just remove any charts that you don't want and maybe add more charts that you think is relevant to your website. One thing to note is that this tip is only applicable if you work with standardized data sets like the one from Google Analytics, Google Search Console, Google Ads, and some more. There are a bunch of free templates available on Looker Studio. You may browse the report gallery to see if there's anything that you could put into use right away. These templates could save you hours or days of work. One of my previous video, I've covered how you could use the template from the gallery in detail. While it's an old video of mine, so the user interface might look a bit different because there are a few updates since then, but the steps are pretty much the same. I'll put the link in the description below in case you're interested. Next, we have the shortcuts to help us make the repetitive tasks fast. In all the BI tools that I have used, there are always a shortcut key to make your work faster. In Looker Studio, the shortcut key is quite commonly used in other applications that you don't even need to memorize as you may already know or familiar with them. So I'm going to just list them here so you can grab them. First in the list, we have the Control C or Command C for the copy, Control V for paste, we have Control Z for undo, Control Y for redo, and if you want to select all the elements, you can use Control A. Next, for the text styling and stuff like that, we can have bold for Control B, italics for Control I, and we still have much more here for you to grab. Can take a look or screenshot this in case you need it in the future.